Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am going to explain the taking of the Android applications to the market related to the mobile application development. So at the end of this session, you will be able to understand the entire process of the publication of the Android application, including the versioning of the applications also. So let us start with some groundwork. Okay, preparing the application for the publication, okay, it requires a lot of steps which have to be followed by us. Okay, that is, you can see on the screen that first we have to sanitize the app. Okay, it means a cleaning of the Android applications and cross checking of the application's resources, means whatever the resources we have used for the Android application development, we have to check that particular resources are used or the not. Okay, and then revisit app's manifest. Okay, means whatever request or the permissions we have to take from the particular authorities, we have taken or not. Okay, and verify the readiness of the remote server, means we have to sort of provide certain services to the Android application users also. Okay, so we have to verify that the server is ready for that service providing or not. Okay, and then obviously deciding the pricing model, means we have to decide the correct price, okay, for the applications used by the users. And then finalizing the agreements. Okay, this is the major issue, okay, in the market, because we have to make the agreement for non-compliance. Okay, then next is the create promotional material. Okay, nowadays there is a lot of marketing strategies are there, so we have to deal with correct one and to reach the particular user in the correct way. So it is very essential. First, let us start with the sanitizing the app. As you told earlier, that removing of the some non-used parts of the application development, means while developing the applications, we took various resources for the Android application developments, but at the end we will come to conclude that a certain applications resources are not used, okay, and are none of the use. Okay, so it should be removed, otherwise the size of the application will get overweighted and it will hamper on the application's popularity. Okay, so we have to remove this all debrises. That is you can see that resource files which are not used and the Java source files, okay, which are used for the testing and the debugging of the Android applications, and then log statements obviously, which are used for checking the Android application is working or not, and then some libraries, okay, which are not used. So we have to remove all this to impress the user. Next one is cross checking of the Android applications resources. Okay, because there are, as I told earlier, that some resources are taken during the development, but at the end we conclude that certain resources are not used. Okay, and another one aspect is we have taken the certain resources, but we have to check that it fits to the particular position or the particular situation or not. Okay, it means you can take the certain image files, okay, and but it is not situated correctly, okay, at the particular folders. Okay, so it should be removed. Okay, means whichever one is most impressing one or the suitable one for that particular position, we have to deal with only that resources, otherwise the other resources should be simply removed. The next one is the revisiting the app manifest. Okay, in this we have to check that we have to ensure that app package is unique. Okay, otherwise if the application of that name is already available in market, then it will create a issue, because we have to make available it on the Play Stores, okay, and then it will be stored on the user's device. Okay, but if there is already a another one application which holding the same name, okay, then it will not be installed, or the some issues will be raised there. So it should not be happen that, okay. So it is the responsibility of the Android application developer to check that particular application with the same name is existed or not, okay. And whatever the contents which are used by the another source as it is, okay, we have to deal with them, and we have to take the permission with them, permission of them to for the Android application development, because there are some issues like copyrights and patents are there, okay. For that we have to deal with these aspects. Next one is the verifying the readiness of the remote server. It means the enterprise server, okay, which is at the back end, which providing the functionality to the Android applications which is installed on the user's device, okay. Whenever some certain operations are performed on the user's app, then it is directly fetched the data at the remote server. It means the enterprise server which providing the certain data and facilities like services to the user. So it is the responsibility of the developer to check that a particular server is ready for that providing the service or not, okay. And it is performing the all the transaction or the processes in correct way or not, okay. Otherwise it will create a chaos, and then a lot of complaint if raised against in the market by the user, then it will hamper on the publicity. It means it will create the bad publicity of the Android applications, so it should not be happen, okay. So it is the care which should be taken by the developer. And another one is to ensure that they are prepared for the anticipated load in terms of the user and data. It means server should be able to handle the large number of the user and large number of the data, okay. Because at the time of the increasing number of the data or the increasing number of the users, it should not be overloaded, and service should not be hampered, okay. So there is one question for you guys, that why it is necessary to choose the unique package name for the application, okay. So the answer is the application package must be unique, as I told you earlier, because if there is already one application is available in the market which is holding the same name, okay, then it will create the problem, because it will we have to deal with the storing of the our application on the Play Store, and then user will be get downloading this application on the user's device, okay. But if two applications are holding the same name, so it is not going to hold the both applications, okay, then it will create the chaos, and then the bad publicity will hamper the popularity of the application. So it should not be happen. So it is the care taken by the Android developer that it should not be happen. So deciding the pricing model, it is also one of the major issue in the Android application publishment, okay. Because the usefulness and the money which can spend by the user for that application, it should be taken into consideration for deciding the pricing model, okay. So it should not be overpriced or underpriced, okay. So particular issues are raised by the users, and particular aspects are according to the developers also. So in between them they have to deal or the finalize one amount for the applications, okay, so that user has to pay for the getting the services for that applications, okay. And another one issue is the app is made available for the market, means it is made available worldwide, okay. So on the basis of the different countries, their pricing will be different, okay, because the currency is varying between different countries. So it should be taken into consideration by the developer. Next one is the create promotional material. As we can see that nowadays marketing is become a big funda, okay, to get reach to the particular user and particular to impress the particular user, okay. So various products are there for creating this promotional material, that is the description of the Android application, okay, screenshots of the apps okay, and some videos, okay, it should be made available during the some social medias or the televisions, like, okay, and it should be spread worldwide. It should create the image of our brand, okay, so that user will get attracted to our application, okay. And with the Android application, we have to provide some guidebook and text, okay, which provides the description of the working of the our Android application, so that it is easier for the user to handle this application. And finalize the legal agreement. As I told you earlier, if you are using certain services or the certain products of the third party Android application developers, then you have to get the permission of that particular developer to use this during development of your Android application, because of some issues like copyrights and patents, okay. Otherwise it will create the violence of this some legal violation, okay. And during this creational of promotional materials, you have to select the particular screenshot very carefully, so that we'll get more downloads of the Android applications. And we have to show all the facilities in good manner, okay, so that it should not be happen that some services are there but it is not reached to the user, that's why some downloads are reduced, okay. It should not be happen, okay. And you have to design the high quality icon for your Android application so that it is recognized by the user, okay. So these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.